performers ever seen on the British boxing stage. But are the great days gone forever? That's the big question, really, tonight. The bookies think so. They've got him as a 5-2 outsider. But Nigel Benn says Steve Collins has relit the fuse. I'm up for this big time, he says. Just watch me. We've heard the chimes. Can he turn back the clock then?
Well, it's going to be, I think it's going to be very difficult. You can never underestimate him. He is a fighter. He will be out there. He's a puncher as well. He's got a tremendous heart, so he'll be trying so hard. But in Collins, you've got a guy who's really at the top of his game, so self-confident, has enormous belief. So I think this is going to be a very tough night for Benn. It's how much desire he has left. In the last couple of fights, it looks as if the desire has gone, but he says it's back. He says he wants this big time. He's got it all there to prove.
Well, he was halted by a twisted ankle in the last fight, and there were unkind suggestions after that that even this great warrior had found that an injury of convenience. They even said that he'd quit, which is a tough thing, I think, to say about a fighter who's been in the kind of fights that Nigel Benn has been in down the years. Look at the reception for Benn. His popularity is unquestioned.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the current super middleweight champion of the world, the Celtic warrior, Steve Collins.
The Celtic warrior is on a high that he's waited for all his life, and he just doesn't want it to end. This is a really tough man from a boxing family. His uncle even beat Reggie Gray in the ring. A man who honed his professional skills alongside the great Marvin Hagler in America. And like Hagler, he's prepared himself in seclusion, away from his family, to prepare for this battle. Never stopped, tough as iron. Last time he said, Benn's punches just bounced off me. I don't feel pain.
He's a tough guy. Great chin. He took some very good punches off Benn, and he never flinched. And he's really single-mindedly, he's really at his peak. He really believes in himself, and so strong, so committed.
Oh, look at all this, even before the start. They look as if they want to fight right now, don't they? This is personal, believe me.
Yes, they're both very, very up for this fight. And they had to be pushed apart at one stage there.
And what's behind all that is that Steve Collins said at the launch of this fight that he would retire Benn permanently, maybe even as quickly as two rounds. Benn didn't like that at all. There's the tale of the tape. They're both 32 now. Collins, the taller man, he's right on the 12-stone limit. There was a bit of byplay yesterday, the Benn cap suggesting he didn't really make it. I don't think it'll amount to much when it comes to it. The reach about the same. Slight advantage to Benn. And There's some more statistics for you. Between them, they've had 501 rounds and 23 World Championship fights. A really big fight atmosphere here in Manchester for this one. And we're just about all set to go. Ben, to me, looks back in Dark Destroyer mode.
He certainly has the mood, but if you see Collins, he's very, very up for this as well. He's a tough guy. This looks set to be a wonderful battle. It fizzled out last time, but I think we're set for something very big.
Top of the bill, we move into the super middleweight division. This contest is conducted and sanctioned under the rules of the WBO, and the officials appointed for this contest are the supervisor from the United States, Mr. Nick Karasiotis. The British Boxing Board of Control supervisor is Mr. John Morris, and the steward in charge, Mr. Tom Pendry, MC, Shadow Minister for Sport. The judges for this contest, Mr. Dennis Nielsen of the USA, Mr. Gordon Boltman from the USA, and Mr. Roy Francis from London. And the referee in charge of the action for this contest, from Derby, England, Mr. Paul Thomas. The timekeeper at the bell, Mr. Frank Capewell from Sheffield. My lords, ladies and gentlemen, boxing fans across Europe, Asia, and around the world, it's big fight time. Promoted by Frank Warren for Sports Network in association with our sponsors, Adidas, The Sun, and ART, who proudly present a contest of 12 three-minute rounds to decide the WBO Super Middleweight Championship of the World. Between introducing the boxers, and firstly, from the red corner, wearing the all-black trunks, and coming from Ilford in Essex, England, he weighed in at 11 stone, 13 pounds, that's 167 pounds. In his professional career, he has had 47 contests, 42 wins, 35 by way of the big KO with 4 losses and 1 draw. And tonight appears in his 16th world title contest. He comes to the ring, the former WBO middleweight champion of the world and former WBC super middleweight champion of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Dark Destroyer, Nigel Benn. And across the ring, ladies and gentlemen, in the blue corner, coming from Dublin in Ireland, wearing his familiar tartan trunks and weighing in at an even 12 stone, 168 pounds. His professional record of 36 contests, he has 33 wins, 18 by way of KO with 3 losses. Tonight he appears in his 7th World Championship and defends his title for the 5th time. He's the former WBO middleweight champion and the current WBO super middleweight champion of the world, the Celtic Warrior, Steve. The referee, Mr. Paul Thomas, will now give his instructions to both boxers.
OK, for I saw you both in the dressing rooms, you know what I expect of you. I'm here to enforce the rules, so give me a good, clean fight. OK, best of luck to both of you.
And the verbals carry on as Paul Ladies Thomas, the Derby shopkeeper, gives his instructions for the biggest fight of his 20-year refereeing career. Freddie Roach with a last word for Steve Collins. I doubt if he's really hearing it. Here we go. Collins, Benn, 2. Collins has beaten Eubank twice. Will he beat Benn twice as well? Or does Benn rediscover the old fire tonight? corner side work.
And it's really started as a brawl.
Might go on as a brawl as well, mightn't it? This might not be pretty. It might be pretty savage.
Yes, I think this is going to be about who's the toughest in there tonight.
Good left hook from Collins, got through there. Ben just wanting to hold on for a moment. Ben renowned as the big puncher, but of course Collins has never ever been knocked out or stopped. All his three defeats in big championship fights and on points, and two of them on split decisions. World title fight for Ben, the ninth for Collins.
It's still very, very untidy.
Collins denying Ben the room. There's a good right hand there. Collins wanted a trade. Rough, grueling inside work in the opening round. A lot of the punches are missing. Good right uppercut there, though, from Ben, who leant away, got the punch through inside, but Collins really does have the original granite jaw.
The both men are really trying very, very hard. They're missing with most of the punches.
Nothing very scientific in this opening round, but I wonder if this is going to develop into a grueling long-distance thriller. Left hand goes in from Collins on the right from Ben.
Collins goes through with a couple of decent ones inside.
It's fairly similar to what we saw the first time, isn't it?
Yes, both missing quite wildly, very rough and rugged.
A frenetic opening round. Judgment Night Boxing continues, and don't forget, after all this, we're going to be off to Las Vegas for Judgment Night Part 2, the Sky Box Office promotion, with Tyson Holyfield topping the bill. Do stay up.
That was very much in that. I thought Collins maybe just did more than Ben in the first round, landed with a few more clean shots, but it was very untidy work.
Second round. Steve Collins, as always, in the tartan trunks. Ben in his habitual solid black. Ben's plan, I know, is to hit Collins with hard punches relentlessly for 12 rounds and try to break down even this most resilient of men. He said, I never really had the chance to get the job done last time. Collins with two good left hands getting through. Not renowned as a big puncher, Steve Collins, but he does wear you down with his relentless, marauding style. Hits coming dangerously close together there.
Collins getting through with the right and the left there. He's so very strong.
Left hand again. Ben gets in with the right.
But I think just fractionally, Collins beating Ben to the punch.
Collins has had so many hungry years as an electrician and then a barman, shut out of the big money, that he doesn't want to get the limelight go. But Ben says he's absolutely determined to get back up there. Furious stuff. Another of those left hooks from Collins. He's having some success with them, Ben.
Yes, he's just having the better of the work inside. He's just getting his punches are a little bit cleaner. He's just getting them off first.
Another left hook there, this time from Benn, but Collins just took the punch and carried on working. That happened in the first fight, in the third round, and that might be a bit dispiriting for Benn when he unleashes his biggest punches and they don't have an effect.
Yes, that's where it's going to get hard for Benn. Collins is so immensely strong. He takes the punches so well. He comes firing back.
Really set himself for the left hook to the body there, Benn, too. This is going to be a war of attrition, you feel.
It's a real test of strength and perseverance.
Paul Thomas might be a busy man as well, the referee. Watch the use of the head, warning to Collins. Again, he rather charged in, and the head coming very dangerously close together at the end of round two. Welcome back to the 9X, packed for the big fight. Nigel Benn with Kevin Sanders and Peter De Freitas in the corner with Denny Mancini. Action from round two here.
Again, it's still messy, but Benn got through that good left hook there. Collins always came back with something. I had that a very even round. There's still not much in these rounds. Still, they haven't gotten through with good combinations or good punches yet. Still very rough, very aggressive, and just a test of strength.
Watch the use of the heads, says referee Paul Thomas. Don't walk away when I'm talking to you. They just want to get on with it. Third round. Benn bidding for his third world championship. There is the danger of a cut, isn't there, with the way the heads are flying in here.
Yes, and I think that would be a very bad finish to a fight if one of them was cut with a clash of heads.
Good jab there from Benn. You do get the impression that this crowd is very much pro-Benn. There's a sentimentality. That's a great right hand, though, from Collins.
But both fighters, they're throwing the punches, they're both very much off balance. They're not getting the proper leverage because they're both reaching in so much.
Had a lot of this kind of close quarter combat in the phone box, so to speak. It's a good right there, though, from Benn, who looks sharp and hungry again here. Good work from him again, and making Collins miss. The snappier stuff from Benn just in this phase.
As he was landing with that short, sharp punches there.
Another good combination from Benn. He's been written off before in his career and come back to confound the critics. Will he do it again here?
Collins trying to fight back there off the ropes, but he's not getting the room he needs to get through with his punches.
Well, this is grueling, strength-sapping stuff, but this is what they've locked themselves away for. Collins going down on one. It looked more like a slip to me than anything else there.
Yes, it looked a little like he was off balance, but Benn again lands with that good left hook.
Big one, wasn't it? Collins took that again. Can he carry on taking those? Really warming up in round three. Benn's had the better of this round, for my money.
Yes, for me too. He's just getting through the cleaner punches. Collins work a bit ragged. He's missing quite wildly, and he's off balance too much.
Benn had gone off the boil since his savage and tragic fight with Gerald McClellan. But so many people have been saying he's a shot fighter, that it's all over for him, that maybe, that has motivated him to produce one of his special performances. Let's see as it develops. This is a Benn round at the moment.
Yes, he's just got through with the better, cleaner work.
And guess who we've got watching here, an old friend of both of them.
Very, very interesting to see him here.
Glenn's got it level so far. I have Benn ahead after three rounds. But it's early. All Collins, big left hand. Benn's knees just seem to bend a little bit there.
The left hook was very solid, and the right hand was a good one from Collins.
This Irishman is so gritty, and there's another good shot. Stepping off and hitting with another right hand. Collins with a restatement of his credentials in the fourth.
Collins is just giving himself a little bit more room. He's landing his shots. He needs the room to land.
Collins gets the lead.
Well, it's as if Collins rather felt that Benn has got the better of things in the previous round and has really come out meaning business. Good stuff from him again there. Left jab, right hand, and an uppercut there.
He's just found the range a bit better, and again he lands with that right hand.
And again. Now, this is where Benn's deep down desire may be tested. Once again, the combination. This is easily the best stuff so far from Collins, settling down.
This is work. He's not as ragged now. He's given himself a little bit more room. He's starting to rattle off the left, right, and he's starting to find his range well.
Very, very savage-looking body shot from Collins. Really sunk it in. And he's beginning to tee off a little bit. Rather ominously for Benn in this round. He's got the range with the jab. The right hand's thudding in two.
For the first time, nothing really good coming back from Benn. He's just stuck on the spot there, getting caught with these right hands.
Fourth round, this is the round, of course, where the injury occurred in the last fight. Benn got home with a left hook. But once again, he finds everything just bouncing off Steve Collins. Goodness me, he must be a hard man to fight. Bit of puffiness under the right eye of Benn has developed. Maybe those right hands have done it.
And he's getting caught with uppercuts inside. This is a very good round for Steve Collins. And not a great deal of work coming from Benn.
Last 20 seconds of a good round for Steve Collins. But Benn, you feel, isn't done with yet.
The zip's gone out of Benn's work as he struggles to find the range.
Welcome back. Now, dramatic things are happening in that Benn corner. Kevin Sanders, the trainer, is saying one more round to Benn and I'm going to pull you out. I'm not going to see you beat. They're saying it now.
Come on. We're not letting you get a beat. One more round.
One more round. Well, what about this, Glenn McCrory?
Very interesting. I'm not sure whether you say one more round like that and I'm going to pull you out, because there was very little cut from Benn. So there's distress signals in the corner. They're not happy with his work.
Collins catching him repeatedly in that last round. Has the fire gone out for Benn after a bright start? They both swap thunderous headshots. Ben's really going for it. But is it one last rally from him? Bearing in mind what we heard in the corner.
We'll never forget, when Benn is hurt, that's when he's always at his most dangerous.
Collins has taken control in a big way. Has Benn got anything left in the fight?
He just seems to be struggling a little bit to find his way. The punches aren't coming back from Benn. Collins getting through with a good left hook there.
Collins wants this so much. Wants to stay at the top. Wants the limelight. Wants the big fights. Benn has been there and done it. Does he have the hunger to go through all the pain and long, hard fights like this to try and get back there again.
Well, this is where he has to show it. This is where he's got to pull something out. If there's any fire left, this is when he needs it most.
Steve Collins is some fighter, underrated, gritty, marauding forward again.
Neutral corner, take time.
Well, the referee sending him to neutral corners, and Collins is having a point deducted, but I think that's for the head work. 1 point off. Good refereeing by Paul Thomas there, the way he made it absolutely clear to everyone what was going on. But Collins' answer is two thunderous rights to the head. Is he lining up Benn here for the final assault?
These are good punches coming in from Collins, and Benn looks hurt there. He's looking over at the corner. He looks distressed.
I wonder whether we're watching the final few minutes, final few seconds even, in the career of one of Britain's most exciting fighters of all time. Will the corner pull him out at the end of the round? There is the threat of that, judging by what we heard last time, unless that was just a threat to try to get him going. Good right hand from Benn. What's that psychology from Sanders, the trainer, or did he mean it?
But Benn hadn't been really badly hurt in the last round, so I think he was just trying to tell him that he's got to do something or I'm going to pull you out. But again, Collins keeps landing with good shots, and Benn just floundering at times.
Rather tired walk back to the corner by Benn. Let's see what's going on there this time, if we can. Well, I think I heard Benn say one more.
Well, he's distressed, definitely. He's been caught with some good hard punches in that round. You just wonder how much more he can take. But in the last round, it certainly was marvellous work from Collins. He's full of fire. He's landing with good punches. Look how many more Collins has landed than Benn. Almost double.
Here comes round six. I think Collins won that last round, but of course he had a point deducted for a low blow. So it will probably go down as even on the scorecards. But make no mistake, at this point, Collins is in control. Agree, Glenn?
Yes, very much so. And a good right hand landed again. These are not happy moments for Benn. He's not finding his rhythm. He's landing good punches to Collins, but Collins is taking them so well and come back with better ones.
It's again coming dangerously close. Oof. Well, he's letting go with attempted haymakers, Benn, in the hope of taking Collins out. Oh, that's a great right hand from Benn, and again, Collins hardly blinked as he went home. He's unbelievably tough.
He really is. He takes such a good shot. Benn landed with a really good one. Collins came back with three of his own that all landed.
If Benn loses this one, there surely is no place left for him to go. We've had retirement speeches for him before, but it really would be the end, I think.
Collins working away with the right uppercut there. Two good little left hooks.
Benn is beginning to fight now in just little fits and starts. Looks like the early fireworks have kind of fizzled out a bit, doesn't it?
And defensively this one, Ben's very bad. The right hands that Collins throws are all landing. His head is starting to dip and he's been caught with his head down.
Mistake. Benn's landed with some very, very big punches in this fight, but he just can't shake Collins. The man is an absolute rock, or so it seems anyway.
Well, Benn really must be thinking what he has to do to make an impression on this man.
body shot was a good one from Collins. Watch these heads, says the referee. Paul Thomas is having a good one in there. Riding control, and not an easy fight to ref either. Ben winks at the referee. He's looking more tired, Ben.
He's looking very tired. His head's starting to drop. You wonder if any confidence is going.
Rocked a little bit there by the left hook, just sending back a couple of paces. Still from the memory bank comes the left hand, but he threw so much into that one, he lost his balance. And, well, let's get a word if we can here with the WBC super middleweight champion, Robin Reed, who's with us at ringside. Robin, how are you seeing the world? Before they that, hang on a minute, wait, before we do that, it may be the end of the contest. It is over. It is over. Ben has been pulled out at the end of the sixth round. And Steve Collins retains the WBO super middleweight championship. He has beaten Eubank twice. He has beaten Ben twice. And that must surely be the end for Nigel Benn. Now we can have a word with Robin Reed. Robin, your comments on the fight.
As you saw from the first couple of rounds, they both went at it like two bulls in a china shop. But as you Steve took control in the last three rounds. He was catching Nigel at will with left, right hand combinations. Nigel started to look wary and warier, and he was getting caught more and more. And I think maybe they're right in justified in pulling him out. At the end of the day, you've got to. The box is the main priority, and if your corners see you're taking too much punishment and you're getting hurt, then as big as your heart may be, maybe that's the right decision at the end of the day. Maybe Nigel, he might be obviously going to be disappointed because he's been pulled out the fight, but when he goes back to his changing rooms or he watches the fight again, I'm sure he'll thank his corner men, for doing what they've done, because he was shipping a lot of punishment there. He was getting caught at will with left-right combinations, and I think, obviously Nigel's time is up.
There's his fiancée Caroline in the ring, and look at that. She has been asking him, no, beseeching him, to stop boxing. And I think that embrace says so much. I think it says that really is the end of the great warrior Nigel Benn.
Yes, and I think Steve Collins, he was so tough, he was so hard, it was a great victory. He did what he said he was going to do. He's probably sent Nigel Benn into retirement for a final time. He's just, there's no stopping him. He's so tough, he's so hard. How do you dent him? What a great chin he's got. What great fight. This is really his time, and good credit to Steve Collins.
Magnificent performance again by Steve Collins. He's so underrated, and really sad, I think, to see the final chapter of Nigel Benn. Let's now join our MC Mike Goodall again.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of round six, Nigel Benn has been retired by his corner, leaving the winner and still WBO super middleweight champion of the world, Steve Collins.
Collins is a very underrated fighter. He's still the champion. There's more big money out there, maybe even a fight with the man many people think is the best at this weight in the world, Roy Jones, but Collins would argue with that. He'd say he's the best.
Disappointing end, but my goodness me, that was a fight. Collins victorious. He remains unbeaten as champion. Remember, Judgment Night Part 2 coming up after midnight. We'll take another break. When we come back, more reaction from Manchester.
To call it a day, I can't go on. There might be another Derby Destroyer, but that's fucking it for me. I tried to go out and please the public. That's one thing I like doing, is pleasing the British public. I can't take no more. It's time to call it a day. Thank you.
Well, for all the right reasons, let's hope that is it from Nigel Benn. He's been a wonderful ambassador for British boxing. What a warrior down the years. We've enjoyed some terrific nights with Nigel Benn. He said in the past he would go. Let's hope this time that he genuinely has. There didn't seem very much more left in the tank, did there? But what a representative of British boxing, Barry.
without a doubt, one of the most dynamic fighters of all time. This is the end of an era for us. He's a great fighter. He's, you know, we always knew that it was going to be a very difficult night's work for him. I could see from the very beginning.
Here's Steve Collins, still the champion. Steve, how do you get to be that tough?
I guess it's just born that way, but I have to say, you know, I feel the public, the paying customers have been cheated tonight. Me and Nigel stood toe to toe. It was man to man. We were going to fight till the bitter end. We were going to sort this out once and for all, who the true warrior was. Unfortunately, his corner saw it fit to pull Nigel out. They reckon he was taking the beating, but we would have kept on going. They should have let us fight. We'll fight till the end. They should have let us go to the end, give the public their money's worth. They paid good money to come here tonight, and I feel they've been cheated.
Don't you feel, though, that you had broken Ben's spirit at that point anyway, that you had the fight won?
Let me tell you something. The fight broke Ben's spirit. He was hitting very hard, very often, and he was coming forward. He surprised me tonight. He was giving me a hell of a fight tonight. He was different from the last Nigel Benn. He came to win. And it was toe to toe. I didn't feel in control. I felt I had a handful. And I felt the public should have been allowed to see the fight go to the end. The corner should not have stopped it. I still claim to be the best man out there, but tonight I got my chance to really confirm it. You know, I can't ask for a third match with Nigel because he has retired, and I think he means it this time. But I feel the public didn't get their money's worth tonight. The corner should let the fight go on, because Nigel was there all the way.
Well, this time he's retired, and I guess this time he might actually mean it. We've had retirement speeches from him before in the ring in the last two fights. Would you like to pay a tribute to him? Because I know you've got feelings about him.
I have. Before the fight, I can be a right pain, but that's the way I am before fight time. I have great respect for Nigel Benn. When people look back over the history of British boxing for years to come, they will always remember Nigel Benn as the most exciting fighter in the history of British boxing. Just when they thought Nigel was finished, he'll always come back. And believe me, I know from experience. I've been in there with him.
You don't think he will come back again, do you?
Well, if he does come back, I hope they allow him to fight till the end. Nigel, you're a great warrior. If you want to get it on again, I give everybody a second chance, third chance. I give them all the chances they want. The public want to see it, no problem. But I don't think you will. I think he's retired this time once and for all. I wish him the best of luck with his family. And thanks for a great time of viewing against Nigel Benn.
Now, you've beaten Chris Eubank twice, you've now beaten Nigel Benn twice. What's the fight you want now?
The fight I've been looking for a long time is Roy Jones, but Roy Jones is running scared. He fights nobodies. He fights people with prison records, not boxing records. If Jones doesn't give me the fight I want, people will remember him as the guy who's afraid to fight Steve Collins.
Well done tonight, Steve.
Screw Roy Jones. Let me and Reed get it on. The best in British boxing. Let's get it on.
Well, Robin Reed is there. We'll have a word with him about that in a moment. Now, here's Frank Warren. Frank, could that fight possibly happen, given all the various alliances in boxing that seem to get in the way of so many things? Could we see Steve Collins and Roy Jones?
Roy Jones is now fighting at light heavyweight. He's gone up to light heavyweight. So I doubt very much if you see it at super middleweight. If they want it, they can have the fight. That's not a problem. I'm very disappointed tonight the way the corner behaved with Nigel. They should not have pulled him out. That was not good. But they've done it, and it's too late now to do anything about it. And I think that takes away from Steve. It takes away his victory from him. You know, he's a great fighter, always gives his money worth, value for money fighter, tremendous, tremendous performer, and it's just a shame it's taken away from him. And it's a shame for Nigel to go out that way.
If he doesn't fight Roy Jones next, what fights could be out there for him?
There's a man there right for him, Manchester's Robin Reed. There's a great fight next year.
Well, let's hope you can get it on. Would you like that one, Steve? You would, wouldn't you?
Let's get the champions together. Let's unify the titles. Let's forget this muck in the belt.
Okay, well done tonight. Still the champ, Steve Collins.
And hopefully very shortly we'll get a chance to talk to...